Welcome back to the Proud Show, boys.
Rock and roll.
Love, find common ground to hold the spread of lies and any
America first.
Today we are diving into Justin Trudeau's gun ban. He is now posing a threat on gun owners by banning every single gun in Canada.
Dude, sir, yes,
sir. We're already falling apart. This could be a long day. All right, we've worked out some bugs though since last time. We actually filmed last time most of it with the mic off.
I was so mad. If you could have seen from the video.
Every time I see, no, this is a different time. I was telling jokes I've written like a week and prior to, but the mic was off and I don't want to tell jokes again.
It's all right.
Because they want it. Nothing's funnier the second time to me.
Mm-mm.
All right, so Jack, did you get the Gmail for the document? We are going to be reacting to Justin Trudeau's gun ban video and talking about how banning guns doesn't do crap.
How mentally brain dead some people are.
We're also going to go into how stupid Canada is.
They're Canadians.
Shout out to Canada, you suck.
That's why they're not a part of the United States.
No.
Because they can't
make it. We don't want that crap.
Okay. So do we just start?
Yeah, click on the link.
Okay. So we're watching this now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Open up link.
If you're thinking about buying so...
Yeah, do you want me to...
Here, I'll just clap my hands the moment it starts so we can match up the sound.
We're introducing legislation to implement a national freeze on handgun ownership. What this means is that it will no longer be possible to buy, sell, transfer, or import handguns anywhere in Canada.
I gotta check the microphone.
In other words,
I'm sorry.
We're capping the market for handguns. We're also fighting gun smuggling and trafficking by increasing maximum criminal penalties and providing more tools for law enforcement to investigate firearm crimes. And we'll require the permanent alteration of long gun magazines so they can never hold more than 5 rounds. These are actions that doctors, experts, and chiefs of police have been calling for years, and we're acting on their advice.
You're acting on your
we need
advice.
Less gun violence.
There's no way. I don't think I've heard
we cannot let the gun debate
no, we don't want
become
this,
so polarized that nothing officer. Gets done. We cannot let that happen in our
country. My neighbors are actually liberal.
Yeah.
And the guy's a police officer. Even he won't even budge on guns.
Yeah. It's such a brain dead idea, in my opinion.
All right. But 94% of shootings happen in gun free zones. Think about that.
What's that saying?
Well, yeah, what does that show? That shows that literally only 6% of shootings happen in zones with guns. Let's be honest, they probably got shut down pretty quick.
Yeah.
But let's be honest, if you take away guns, you think someone's gonna be like, oh, gee, guns are taken away. Now let's not shoot anything. Let's not take my car and ram it into people.
It's just like
let's not take a knife. They're not stopping. They're not gonna.
Yeah.
You're not delaying an insane person.
It's just like the idea of drugs.
No.
You can make drugs illegal, but the people that are already going to break the law, they're just gonna break the law again. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. And they still fit the people. The lawbreakers still fit into the category of the people who shoot places. If they can manage to get drugs, they can manage to get guns. And if they're fit into the category of people who shoots up schools, we're going to have a crisis.
And let's just say, civilians that have guns, on average, and everyone feels safer if they have a means of defense for themselves.
Trudeau, we're looking at the next Hitler. All he needs is that stupid mustache. Like a
just
piece of crap.
Creates a new.
He has like a saddle, like a horse whip, and gets a red cape.
Forget Trump's World War III. Nope, this is Trudeau's World War III.
No, it's on him. Actually, that'd be funny though if they went Canada clash with Russia.
Yeah.
They get destroyed.
They get absolutely destroyed. They're
why would I enjoy seeing Vladimir Putin kick Trudeau's butt? Like, not kill soldiers, but just put Trudeau to shame.
Their maple leaf flag would be burning to the ground.
Talking to Biden, those Canadians. They think they're the shiz. No, but Canada's a heck hole. Like, in an assignment I did. Hey!
It's a bit. That was a G-Mac glue.
That was a pretty bad one.
That was. I'm just gonna have an airsoft gun. Should I?
No, we should. No, because then we could keep it right here while we're talking about the gun.
Dude, yes!
This is why.
All right,
this is
cut.
Why you
here,
need
cut.
Guns.
Quick cut. Yeah, yeah, this yeah. Welcome back to the Proud Show, boys.
Rock and roll.
Oh, yeah. No, but we're keeping this in case the intruders come back. Anyway. Anyway, about that piece of crap Justin Trudeau. Let's just talk about how crappy Canada is and how crappy the healthcare is. You go there, you get an injury to the foot, and they're like, nah, wait 5 days. And then when you get there, they're like, looks like it has to be amputated.
And like then, men back in the days, cavemen, they were able to fight off diseases and injuries. You could wait a few more days.
No, in Canada, it's probably worse than caveman time, because you're just sitting at home not doing anything.
1400 BC looking into the future of Canada, being like, whoa, what are they doing?
What a piece of crap. Still is the future, and I still
can't get a good doctor.
Yeah, back to the future, they go to the future, and Justin Trudeau's the leader of the world.
Marty McFly. Hey, Doc, who's this guy?
Run, Marty! It's the Libyans! He just shows up with a machine gun. Holy crap!
Eat this!
Yeah, I'm definitely going back to the 80s.
Yeah.
When times were good and Canada wasn't a piece of crap. Canada no, program. But in a school assignment I got, I'm going back into that drug thing, that okay. Library. There was a library. I don't remember what town it was. I think I'll find it. I'll put the name up in the corner. But in this library, they had this popular, like, protest. Because in the library, there was this machete fight that broke out. They were like, machete fight. There was a machete fight that broke in the library. A gang recruitment going on in the basement with, like, mafia and stuff. They had drug, like, heroin needles. They had a heroin needle in the children's play place.
That's sick.
Look, Mommy! Found a little sword for my Lego guy! Put that down, son!
Probably has AIDS.
Other daddy! Where? Can I play with this? Do what your father told you.
No, it might be like, do what your father told you.
Hey! This is such a good place, though. This is a wild place for the kids. Bring the kids. They got free needles. Alright, but the problem is that the library put in some secret, like, metal detection stuff. They, like, you have to go through metal detection at the very beginning to get in. And they like you can just leave. They even allow you just to leave needles at the front.
Nuh-uh.
They do.
They just have like a needle drop.
They don't put
needles here.
That's mine. That's you're using my needle. I'm sorry. I already injected yours.
Now we know why Canada has a really bad.
No, the homeless problem there is a piece of crap. But anyway, they had the metal detectors, and the town went nuts. Because this was discriminating against the homeless people that were doing drugs in kids' play places. Like,
just, why don't they go do it in their homes on
no,
the side of the road?
Well, because it's too cold. Everyone's like, well, it's too cold. Yeah, but
then don't do it.
You're putting kids at harm. And you can do other things than be homeless. I mean, a grown man should have no problem finding a job.
And here's the thing that surprises me. If they have money to buy freaking heroin,
yeah.
Then go get a job or go pay out
yeah.
some loans.
And there's, like, local bathrooms and, like, gas stations they can use. Like, this is sick. To where the point where we allow people to take heroin around children. This is disgusting. But then the entire town went nuts about this. This is the same place where this guy's taking guns, but he refuses to take away their precious heroin. This is sickening. The shooters probably fit in the category of the drug users.
And again, with the machete fight, bringing back to that, a thing with the guns, if you take them away, people are going to use knives. If you take the knives away, there's always going to be violence.
There's like the kids' book club. Thursday event, kids' book club. Next day event, betting on
machete,
machete fight
machete
in the basement. $50 says he gets his eye gouged out in the first second.
Third event.
You're on.
Third event.
I bet you my heroin needle loses a limb.
Third event, who can shoot the most heroin in their arm?
Now that shouldn't be in a library. Like, at what point do you think of the library as a heroin user place?
I definitely...
Never!
I mean, definitely wouldn't go buy books anymore.
No, definitely not. But another statistic I have.
That's why video game research
says that 1.67 million times last year, just last year, 2021, guns were used in the name of self-defense to prevent an attack. Don't bend the words. Don't say it was someone attacking someone. This was to defend yourself.
That, oh, it's proven.
Yeah, yeah. And, like, and there was only 19,000 gun homicides. That isn't even, like, a number. That isn't even a fourth of the...
No.
...of the defense times.
Oh, it's a proven number. There, weapons are used more for self-defense than it is for actual anger taken out upon people.
No, but would you rather wake up to see your local newspaper saying child found dead in the ditch to mother shoots suspected kidnapper? Would you rather read about that? Like, you decide. Like, picture, like, what point would you go around killing people if everyone could defend themselves, like, really well? Would you target someone without a weapon? Or would you target someone with a weapon?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, no, target anyone.
Yeah.
But just to get them
to a criminal.
Someone's like, Mom, they said to shoot up the school.
The dark web.
That's when we get sued the next week.
Listen, children.
We're encouraging you. I like the TikTok thing with the school.
Yeah.
TikTok is the stupidest piece of crap. Can we talk about that? How stupid TikTok is and the trends.
When, like, the teachers were actually scared because they thought the whole all kids were going to come to school with a freaking gun and trash the school.
They just show up. They're doing the dances while shooting the school. They, like, get up and, like,
I'm sorry, but why can I only see
I can see them, like, setting up their phone, too.
I'm sorry, but why can I only see the GSA kids doing that?
Dude, they are scary. They wear, like, Satan symbols.
I have seen them wear, like, a
no, they have, like, pentagrams and, like, skulls. This is twisted, and these are the people that we're supposed to love. I mean, I don't hate them, and I won't hate them, and I won't do anything to
them. But these are
the
people that we're supposed to bow down to.
But they fit into the category. Yeah, I'm not fitting into the... I'm not bowing down to someone who is wearing a symbol of someone who encourages all the things that the Democrats hate as well.
Yeah. If you're going to take away... It brings us back. If you're going to take away the weapons... You might as well take away the people that are causing it.
Yeah, might as well. Honestly. Holy frick, people. This is the group you love and you can't stop hanging up flags about. You might as well just draw a pentagram on your lawn. Holy crap. No, but also, there's also a fact that statistically, someone who concealed carries is less likely to commit a crime than an actual police officer.
Yeah.
That's a fact. And also, not a single mass shooting has been done by a member of the NRA. Not
really?
A single one. Not a single one. Think
like
about that.
One.
Not a single one. Not a single mass
shooting.
Let that sink in. Not a single mass shooting. The racist, the Nazi, the neo-Nazi group, the NRA hasn't shot a single one. But how come your stupid little GSA is always...
Oh, it's because they're suffering from anxiety because no one accepts them for who they are.
Well, we bully them, of course! No, don't personally... I gotta say this because you people are probably taking this the wrong way. I don't hate gay people.
We don't hate them.
I hate it, though, when they rub it in our face that we're supposed to agree with them.
If I see a gay couple, I don't care. Like, I'll let them be.
No, but people will cancel you if you go to a church that says gay marriage shouldn't be. They're not saying to hate gay marriage. They're saying don't do gay marriage.
They just, that's what they believe.
No, they're not saying discriminate gays. They're saying don't be gay.
Yeah.
They're bending the words. They're bending like we're discriminating them.
And I have a friend. I know a person that... is gay, but they're a part of the church, and they're not gay, but they feel it, and the church doesn't hate on them. They just try. They're trying to teach them things. And
I gotta check the microphone again.
All right, still on.
I'm sorry. I feel like it's just gonna automatically shut off, and I'm gonna.
I know,
dude. This is PTSD. At least
this
nothing.
Is scary.
Nothing electrical has gone wrong though.
That is true.
That is weird. Like, everything was going on wrong last show.
Our water bottles fell off. They ran in, but...
Yeah, that
no
back thing fell.
Problems.
That light is still running, which is a miracle.
Yeah, the light.
Because it took me forever to get working earlier.
Thank you, electricity.
That's when the devil's like, you're dissing on me! You just see a fiery hole open up in the ground. Oh my gosh! And then the microphone cuts out. Oh, it's worse than I thought! No, but should we dive into Roe v. Wade?
Yeah.
I feel like that's a thing that should be discussed. Let's just say that I just want to bring out my first initial point, that doctors, to determine if a baby's alive, is determining heartbeat and brain function. There's function in the brain. They have a mind.
They can feel. They're thinking.
They have emotions. They have body. They have an eye color. They have hair color. They already have a personality developing.
And
inside.
I want to know how you can counteract that. How you can agree with that. That is not a living person. That can think, that is live, that can breathe.
No, that is disgusting. But they're always like, nah, it doesn't count. It's a fetus. Just because it has a different name doesn't count.
And there's some doctors that literally will go at least like a week after it's born.
No, that is disgusting and horrible. Like, and they say like part of it is because the experience the baby has. But think about, like, a kid who is, like, special needs or someone with a learning disability. Are they less value?
Yeah.
Are they less value? Like, if some kid was born with dyslexia, are they less valued than you?
Like, do you go around and if you see a disabled person, you think, oh, I'm better than them?
Also think, if it's all of experience, then how, so are blacks less valuable for not experiencing?
Yeah.
If white people are privileged, according to you, then how come...
How come they're not having a better time?
Yeah.
What we're trying to say is how come, no offense, like how come they should have been aborted?
Yeah. Like, no, I'm saying how come they don't have the experience, though, like, of a white privileged person? Does that make them less valuable?
Yeah.
Or
I thought we were supposed to be searching for equal rights for everyone.
No, I think that some of the greatest evil in American history is done when there was someone else deciding the value. Not just American, world history. Someone else deciding the value of someone else's life, right?
Yeah, that's why monarchy is...
That is every single greatest evil
that's
ever
why monarchy
made.
Is bad, because people just start getting lower and lower and they feel worse and worse.
Dude, Democrats haven't been this mad since we took away their slaves. Checkmate. Dude, I'm probably going to have a bomb at my house. You're starting my car tomorrow.
Yeah. Car bomb!
Just see the car, my stupid Pontiac, fly in the air.
Hey, so
they probably try and install the bomb. They open the door and the door would fall
off. Yeah,
the
door would fall off. They'd probably be doing you a favor.
Yeah, the bomb just randomly goes off for no reason. Like, dang it!
Darn!
No, but honestly, though, which is also wrong is when there's like when they have the late term abortions, like they always say abortions are early. There was 10,000 to 12,000 late term abortions. Like, think about that. Let that sink in. Like, that's babies that have way more experience. Like, they're getting more experienced.
That's a baby.
No, that.
And you know what makes me sick? You know what makes me feel sick?
Wait,
is when.
Door. Wait, I'm on my right hand.
Guys, this is why we need guns.
Yeah, honestly, though, like...
What is it?
But, like, with, like, late-term abortions, it is also, like, the father's choice legally. Oh!
They're seeing our eyes!
I can blur them. Don't worry.
I'll shoot the camera. Just kidding.
You don't even know my eye color. I can be hazel. I can be blue. I can be green. Never know.
You guys will never know.
Alright, so we're going to go back into Roe v. Wade, that it's 100% free to put up a baby for adoption. And let's just talk about how you can choose abstinence over killing a freaking baby. No, but they act like it's the hardest thing in the world to practice. For once in your life, don't be a slut, honestly.
And don't give me that freaking rape excuse, alright?
No, we're gonna talk everything about it. You can abort a baby if you're raped, and if you have proof, because... Let's be honest, so many Democrat girls are like, I've been raped. And then like five...
Rape is... It's not... That's I mean, common. It's common, but it's not as common as unexpected pregnancy due to...
Come on.
Being stupid.
10,000 to 12,000 late-term abortions, that was all rape. You're telling me? You're telling me that every man, every one of those is... No, they're horrible women who can't practice abstinence. You know, like when a teenager finds a baby, she's like, crap, mom's gonna kill me, and then the baby's like, crap, mom's gonna kill me. You know, it's the loop.
It's a never-ending loop.
That baby's up in heaven like, well, shiz, there goes my chance. I had a determination to go down to Earth and be the change, but I guess my mom killed me before I even took a breath.
Watch that be the person that was gonna cure cancer.
Yeah. Well, I got raped, okay? What can I say? No, but it's like a piece of... What kind of piece of crap, though, doesn't practice anything? Like, this country is encouraging this crap, though. They're encouraging, like, strippers. They're encouraging these people. Like, girls look up to their idols that are, like, strippers on TikTok.
Like our last episode.
Drag kids. Like, you know, like, they're like, child prostitution's horrible. Anyway...
Drag kids coming
Pride Month.
Get all properly fluffed.
Get, yeah.
It's my favorite part.
And I like the one that's like, I'm Sarah Pride.
I had a nightmare about that last night.
Dude, I checked under my bed for that one. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's gonna fluff me while I'm sleeping.
Oh, that sounds
good. That does sound horrible.
No.
I was fluffed while I was sleeping.
I don't know.
I'm gonna abort the baby because men can get pregnant.
I don't know. What I think is, as long as you have a brain and you can think, like, you were birthed into this world by your mom.
Yeah.
And imagine if she aborted. You wouldn't be here, so...
No, every experience you had in your life, just think about every experience you've had in your life. Think of every good moment, every positive moment. Think of all you've learned.
And you just stole that from someone.
Yeah. All of that was taken away. Each and every second... you've ever lived has been taken away. Plus, they say the birth control pill, I am not able to talk. Alright, anyway, the birth control pill, they say the side effects are bad, but it's only actually bad if you have pre-existing health problems, to where actual abortion causes, let's see, I wrote a list. Risk of abortion, pelvic pain, uterine damage, bowel and bladder injury, heavy bleeding, or more serious complications... And they say the pill causes bad stuff. These fit in the same group of people who inject hormones in little kids.
puberty blockers.
Anyway, son, bend over so I can shove this needle in your butt.
Freaking dumb.
Why? It'll make you a girl. I don't want to. No! You have to.
You said it. You said you want to wear a dress.
You said you wanted to play with a doll once. I didn't know there was a needle going to get injected in me.
I don't care.
No, but honestly, every parent, though, when their kid says they want to be, like, want to wear a dress or anything, is like, they just want to...
They freak out.
Yeah, they just want to act like their sister or something.
They just want to see the world
burn. Or act like someone that they look up to. Like, so it's like a... It's a weird thing. Parents are doing it for publicity. What, you know, like, there's no way this much kids are gay.
Yeah. Oh, parents, there's no way.
Parents grow them up and push them into this so that it's like the, my kid goes to homeschool, my kid goes to charter school flex. My
kid's
gay.
You think they wanted to do that?
My kid's gay. Yeah, no kid wanted to get their freaking nuts chopped off. No kid. What do you want to do? I want to wear a dress. Oh, do you want to get your nuts cut off too? Maybe.
You think kids that are... 8 years old, eight years old. I hear all those stories and people where they're like, oh my gosh, it's so precious. My 8 year old son came out today and he.
It's not precious. It's disgusting.
And it's like, who was putting those ideas into his head? Because I know he didn't just wake up one morning and go, mommy, I want to be a girl.
Let's be honest. None of your siblings probably, I hope, deep down want to date the same gender. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
Like, anyone who grows up in a family like mine, who was taught good values, isn't going to deep down want to date boys.
Yeah.
Not one of my brothers is slightly...
And I'm sorry, but we were born to like the other gender.
There's a reason the bodies are built different. I don't want to hear this crap that a woman is determined by thoughts.
I'm sorry if children are watching this, but this works, not this.
No.
Or this.
Hot dog.
All right. Hot dog goes in the bun. You can't eat two hot dogs.
Okay, stop.
Sorry, bro.
I'm just gonna bleep that whole part.
It just shows me.
Alright, should we go into Biden's biggest fails?
Yeah.
Alright, while you pull that up, let's just talk about Biden saying poor kids are just as bright and just as good as white kids. That is the one of the
that
most
is so racist.
That is one of the most racist things I've ever heard. Like, and they still act like, and he's supposed to be their advocate for racism.
He's like, he is friendly to all. He loves all.
Did they? Ah! Ow! He got that again.
Ouch! See, that's the only reason I don't think we should have guns is because friggin' idiots that don't know how to use them. Oh, that hurts so bad.
At least it's an airsoft. Someone in the comments are like, "It could. What if it was a real gun?" Someone just sets a real gun on a table, loads it, cocks it.
Okay, are we doing...
Here, wait, let me clap when you hit
wait,
start.
So is,
here, wait,
so should I just start from the start?
Wait, countdown when you start it.
3, 2, 1.
Well, the best way to get something done, if it holds near and dear to you that you like to be able to... Anyway.
Anyway.
We're ready to get a lot done.
This is just in 1 year.
I just got one. He got me.
He's snapping. Oh yeah, everyone's seen this. This is on our outro. Dude, he had like a
Mr. President.
He had like a mini stroke.
Really?
And the president.
Why is it just so awkward?
He tries to act so young.
No, he does, but he looks like a caveman. He talks like one too.
Anyway. We have fewer democracies in the world today than we did 15 years ago. Fewer! Not more, fewer!
What are you gonna do about it?
Chill out.
There are other countries.
Sitting here yelling about
that's
it.
What is he gonna
do? Just remind him.
That sniffing your head.
Why would I not be for
it? Anyone who votes
for it. That's a serious question, right? Is it acceptable to me? Come on.
Because of the actions we've taken, things have begun to change. End of quote. In the past, in the past 3 weeks,
I'm especially honored to share the stage with Brittany and Jordan and Nathan and Margaret Catherine. I love those barrettes in her hair, man. Tell you what. Look at her. She looks like she's 19 years old.
Dude, this is a... this is a lot... No, it started off funny, but towards the end, it's getting worse.
Anyway.
Meeting's going here in Cornwall.
Very well. She's like, come on, don't answer.
How do you realistically and physically keep these families from coming to the U.S. when things will not get better in their country right away?
What did he say?
The journey of 1,000 miles.
He just walked away from talking. Such an idiot.
Oh my gosh. His run. I love his run.
Dude, if I saw that running at me, I don't know if I'd run towards it or away.
That's when the gun bill is. That's when we need the gun bill.
Joe, run out there to show you're young. If you don't, I'm taking away the balls off your walker.
Why are you so confident it'll change his behavior, Mr. President?
I'm not confident it changed his behavior. What the hell? What are you doing? When did I say?
Dude, I'd be afraid if the president started yelling at me. I'm like, the Secret Service is going to be at my house tonight.
Straight. I said, what will change their behavior is if the rest of the world reacts to them and it diminishes their standing in the world.
But I feel like they're trying to do like a Guardians of the Galaxy, like slow-mo walk.
There's like music.
But they're all just old.
$1.9 trillion.
Why do I feel like that's going into my ear though? I feel like he's behind me when I hear that.
Maybe he's peeking around.
Like I turn around. Oh my gosh!
No!
You just set this behind that.
Yeah.
Thank you, Boris.
Dude, is there a well?
I want to thank that fellow down under.
Look, there's a well!
We'll show it after the video. We're gonna take a picture of that when we're done. We're trying to support guns and we have a gun missing.
It literally, I just got another shot by every video.
I'm so happy we got that. To this day, legend has it they're still walking.
Thank you.
Thank you. Dude, that kind of made me happy, though.
I know. Brought joy to my eyes.
Dude. Let's go, Brandon. I agree. Oh, man.
YouTube can't take that down, right?
No.
Someone named Brandon.
No. Joe Biden said it, too. Joe Biden supports
it. He supports it. Let's go,
Our
Brandon.
President supports it, so shut the heck up.
If you don't support Joe Biden, then you don't
support Like Susan Wojcicki's watching our video, I'd be like, I love this show! Let's go, Brandon!
Yeah!
He has a Let's Go Brandon tattoo on her shoulder. Yeah! They're getting monetized right now! Just kidding. I already got, like, demonetization.
Yeah, we already got
it. My last few. We're doing great, though. If we're taking YouTube off, that means you're doing a good job.
I hope you guys start commenting, because we want to see them.
No. So comment your arguments. I like... Why don't I take a sip mid-sentence on? Comment your own...
Hey, guys, could you make sure to...
Anyway.
Comment so that we can see you guys fail.
I want to comment. Come on, destroy me.
Come on. We'll see.
You strike me down, and it'll only make me stronger. Huh? Come on. We'll go into a video arguing about your comments. So, do your worst. Come on.
Oh, yeah, we can make, like, shorts. We can make shorts of us commenting and replying to your comments.
Yeah.
We want to see it. Come on, bring the thunder.
Look forward to crushing you.
Bring the thunder.
I already get in arguments on Twitter.
Really?
Yeah.
How bad?
I'm currently in one with some guy with, like, a pride flag in his thing, and he's, like, using things like, cis woman. I'm like, what the frick does that mean?
Oh, you remember when you got an argument on YouTube, on that one comment section?
Oh, yeah, about the guns?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, one guy said I supported school shooters.
Didn't he say you was like a Nazi?
No, he said I was like a terrorist, like a domestic terrorist. Yeah, you're a terrorist. I need to try and find that, though. It's probably lost
some
in the section.
Some people nowadays.
All right. Yeah, hail Hitler. All right.
Anyway.
Guns don't kill people. I do. Anyway. Like and subscribe. And comment your best argument. Let's go, Brandon.
Let's go, Brandon. I agree. Clouds rain, train whistles blow, and guitars play. Preachers preach, farmers plow, wishes go.